The Owen James Report is brought to you by
This program is brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care. Grace Kennedy Money Services has been here for you and your family, here and abroad, because we understand that you're receiving more than money. You're receiving their love. Grace Kennedy Financial Group has been here for you because we know it's more than just investments, insurance, or banking. It's about security and creating a path to realizing your dreams. For 90 years, honesty, integrity, and trust. The Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.
Good evening. This is the Owen James Report, and we begin with news on the foreign exchange market, where both the benchmark American dollar as well as the British pound strengthened against the Jamaican dollar, whilst the Canadian dollar weakened. The greenback gained 24 cents Jamaican, closing at an average selling rate of $105.58, whilst the British pound gained 26 cents Jamaican to close at $169.99. However, the Canadian dollar fell by 25 Jamaican cents, closing at $100.29. As the Bank of Jamaica continues its liquidity management thrust, today it began offering a one-year unlimited 4% fixed rate US dollar indexed note. The settlement currency rate is $104.51 Jamaican to one US dollar. Now, the first installment of interest will be due on May 12 next year, and the final interest payment will be up to the maturity date of November 11, 2014. Taxes will be withheld at source. News on the Jamaican stock market now, and falls by Sagicor Life Jamaica and NCB mainly triggered modest losses in the indices today. Low volumes characterized today's trading, with just over a million shares changing hands, 20 stocks traded, with 7 advancing, 5 declining and 8 holding firm. The winners included Caribbean Cement, Caribbean Cream, Carreras, DNG, Grace Kennedy, Paramount Trading, the day's big winner, up 9%, and Scotia Group Jamaica. The losers included General Accident, Lasco Manufacturing, NCB, Sagicor Life Jamaica, and Supreme Ventures. Now finally, trend-setting beauty care entrepreneur Jennifer Samuda has done it again. Yesterday, her GenCare brand officially launched the GenCare Mobile Express Day Spa. So how does it work?
Yes, it's technology on board. We realize that people are so high stressed and they would want to do things together, family, weddings, different things. And we decided that what could we do to bring the spa to people? So we decided on the mobile spa. We do have two mobile spas. One is retrofit for the 14 parishes in Jamaica and one is for Kingston. All appointments have to be booked through GenCare at 82 Hope Road.
And that's the Owen James Report. Good evening.
The Owen James Report was brought to you by Grace Kennedy.
This program was brought to you by the Grace Kennedy Group. We choose to care.